Hello everyone, in today's video lecture we are going to see asymptotic notations which are used in design and analysis of algorithm for analyzing the algorithmic behavior, how algorithm behaves as the number of inputs are which are provided to the algorithms are increasing, the amount of the time required for the algorithm to be executed also increases, right? As the number of inputs increases, the amount of the time required for the algorithm to execute also increases. So here this is nothing but the f of n is nothing but the algorithm, how algorithm behaves with the increasing in number of inputs and the amount of the time. Okay, so here this is f of n is nothing but denoting the behavior of the algorithm. So here with the help of what is this big O, why these asymptotic notations are needed? Asymptotic notations are needed to analyze the time complexity of the given algorithm. So here this big O is nothing but whenever terminology big O comes to in our mind, so we need to think about the two things. First is upper bound and the worst case analysis. Upper bound and worst case analysis. Upper bound means the algorithm, this f of n is never going to cross this c into g of n. Okay, it is never going to cross this c into g of n value. Why? Because this c of f of n is upper bounded by c into g of n. F of n value is never going to cross this c into g of n. So here what it says, see, at some point in instance of time n0, after this point in instance of time this n0, after this n0 values, it is so f of n is going to be lesser than c into g of n. Okay, so c into g of n determines here the upper bound for given for the algorithm. So for example, given here, I would like to take one example over here, given one array and we need to search for an element in an array. We are going to search for that element from starting from the first element till the last element. So what can be the worst case? What can be the upper bound for this? What can be the big O of this searching? So here if the element is found at the first position itself, it is going to be the best case. If the element is going to find out at the last position, it is going to be the worst case. So if it is found at the last position, so it is worst case. If it is not found at all, then it will be the again the worst case. So what can be the big O of this? It is nothing but O of n, that is the worst case. Worst case is O of n. What can be the best case? Best case is it is finding at the first position itself. So we are going to see that this f of n, given the algorithm f of n is never going to cross this upper bound. So here what we say, that as the number of inputs are increasing to the algorithm, the amount of the time required for the algorithm to be executed also increases, and then this f of at some point instance in time n0, okay, this n0 has to be, n has to be greater than n0, n0 has to be greater than 1, okay, and this after this point in time, this f of n is going to be lesser than c into g of n. So this is visual graphical representation. How to write it mathematically? How to write it mathematically? The same thing we are writing it in mathematically, that f of n is going to be lesser than or equal to c into g of n. It is lesser than or equal to c into g of n. N has to be greater than n0, and c here the constant c has to be greater than 0. Okay, c has to be greater than 0. If c is 0, it will collapse, right? C is going to collapse, and this n0 has to be greater than or equal to 1. N0 has to be greater than or equal to 1. After this point in time, the algorithm behavior changes. So with the help of this asymptotic notations, we are trying to determine the time complexity of the given algorithm. Okay, so here big O, with respect to big O, we need to just remember two things. One is upper bound. Sorry. one is upper bound and second is worst case analysis. Now why always we think about the worst case analysis? Because whenever the algorithm designer has to design any algorithm, he has to think about all the worst cases that could happen to that algorithm, right? So as a software engineer, we need to always think about the worst possible cases. Okay, so now here, just with the help of this example, you can understand that if element X has to be found, if it is found at the first position, then that is going to be the best case. If the element is found at the last position or not found at all, then that is going to be the worst case. Okay, and if it is found somewhere middle, then it is going to be the average case. So these three cases. So worst case is determined by, it is denoted by big O notation, best case is denoted by omega notation, and average case is denoted by theta notation. Okay, so now let's have a look at this big omega. What is this big omega? As the number of inputs which are given to the algorithm increases, the amount of the time required for the algorithm to be executed also increases. So here we are going to determine the best case possible to that algorithm. So this is f of n is nothing but an algorithm behavior, right? So here f of n is nothing but an algorithm behavior. So at some point in time n0, after this n0, this c into g of n is going to be lesser than this f of n, right? So here we are trying to find out the lower bound. So what is the difference between upper bound or lower bound? Suppose if you are given a paper, right, English paper, so here 0 marks is the lower bound, 100 marks is the upper bound. So here it is, this f of n is never going to come below this c into g of n. F of n is never going to come below this lower bound. So that lower bound we are going to determine with the help of this big omega. Okay, so how to write it in a mathematically, you just fix this in your mind and you can write the mathematical formulation of it. Same it is given in Corman book. Okay, so here f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n. At what point in time this n has to be provided, n has to be greater than n0. C has to be greater than 0, constant has to be greater than 0, and n0 has to be greater than or equal to 1. Getting it? So f of n is greater than c into g of n. C is nothing but a constant. Constant has to be greater than 0. n0 has to be greater than 1. And provided this number of inputs has to be greater than this n0. So if it is given, then we can say that f of n is omega of g of n. Okay, so let's take one example over here. If f of n is 3n plus 2, if f of n is 3n plus 2, then what is the value of c here? F of n is 3n plus 2, then c has to be 2 or 1. Why? Because this constant 2 into g of n or 1 into g of n, right? So here we are going to determine the lower bound with the help of this omega notation. So just remember one thing here, that here it is never this f of, in big O cases, the value of f of n is never going to cross this c into g of n upper bound, and in case of omega, it is this f of n is never going to come down below c into g of n. So that is the lower bound. So big omega, we need to keep in mind two things: lower bound and best cases. And for O notation, we need to keep in mind two things: upper bound and worst case analysis. Now let's move ahead. What is this big theta notation? That is average case analysis. So what is this? It is bounded by the upper bound and the lower bound. What can be the upper bound and lower bound here? Again, take the same example. Given English paper, 0 marks can be the lower bound and 100 marks can be upper bound. It cannot be lesser than 0. It cannot be more than 100. Okay, so that is, we are going to analyze the behavior of algorithm f of n in terms of time complexity, where it has to be never lesser than lower bound and it has to be never more than upper bound. Okay, so how to write this equation again? Just remember this graphical representation. How we can write the same thing in terms of mathematical formulation? F of n is bounded by c1 into g of n, and it is lower bounded by c1 into g of n, and it is upper bounded by c2 into g of n. So where provided this n number of inputs has to be greater than or equal to n0, and this constant c has to be greater than c1 has to be greater than 0 and c2 has to be greater than 0, provided this n0 value has to be greater than 1. So this is average case analysis, okay? Average case analysis. So if this is the case, so whatever we have represented here graphically, the same can be written here in mathematically. If this is the case, then we can say that f of n is equal to theta into g of n. That is average case analysis. Thank you.